That's a Rihanna song, right? Unfaithful. All right, now after finishing first runner-up in last year's Beauty Beating Pilipinas pageant, 22-year-old Janine Marie Tugonon came on stronger this year by besting 29 other candidates over the weekend to be crowned Miss Philippines Universe 2012. Now, fresh from that win, Binibining Pilipinas Janine Tugonon and her court join us here on the morning stage. Now, with her are Binibining Pilipinas International Nicole Schmitz, Binibining Pilipinas Tourism Katrina Jane Dimaranan, first runner-up Elaine K. Mall, and second runner-up Anna Lee Forbes. Congratulations and good morning to you ladies.
Good morning.
I didn't get the memo to wear animal print, so I wore green and I'm the grass of your animal print. All right, guys. All right, well, again, congratulations. I'll start off with you, Janine. Has it really sunk in yet? I know that this has been a dream of yours for a while, and after doing well last year and then now this year really getting the coveted crown, how do you feel?
I feel happy, but at the same time, I really feel pressured because a lot of people are telling me, oh, Shams and Venus made it last year and the other year. So the Philippines should have 3 consecutive years of making it to the Miss Universe. So I'm really, really pressured.
I know that was one of the first things that you even mentioned. I know when
yes.
I got on stage at the coronation night, I said, how do you feel? She goes, I'm excited, but I'm nervous. You're already thinking about it. I mean, that
yes,
soon.
Yes. I am. That was the first thing that comes to my mind.
Now, have Venus and Shamsi said anything about it? Have they shared any sort of piece of advice with you?
Yes. Shamsi texted me and I really, really appreciated it. She said, don't mind negative comments. Just focus on your goal. Focus on the mission. We're here for you. We're here to help you. Just call for us and we will help you.
All right. Well, what do you think that is very uniquely yours that maybe Shamsi and Venus or maybe other of the candidates, necessarily don't have or maybe didn't project that night? What was it about you think that night that got you the crown?
I think last night I felt it. And for me, that's very important. Mm-hmm. If you want to win, you should feel it. You should claim the crown. Mm-hmm. And I think I showed it last night.
All right. Well, that's how much I feel like you guys are really busy because it is about 2 days ago, but it's still, because it is Tuesday morning, but I feel like you probably haven't even gotten any sleep, which doesn't really show.
A few hours of sleep.
You guys are. All right. Well, we were all going to get to know you a little bit more, but Nicole, of course, how are you feeling? I know you're really excited. You're also, this is also your first time with Binibining, Pilipinas, the pageant. And so is it sweeter this time around? I can only imagine.
Of course. You know, I'm very happy to have been successful this time, but of course we worked very hard and we all deserve it.
Now, are there details as to when your international pageant is going to be?
It hasn't been confirmed yet, but I think it's around September, October time. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And we fare very well in the Miss International pageant. Are you feeling that same pressure that Janine is feeling?
Not exactly yet. I think it still hasn't sunk in, but I'm just really excited to have the opportunity to represent the country.
All right, okay. And also representing the country in a tourism pageant.
Hello.
Hello, congratulations to you, Katrina.
Thank you so much.
How are you? How is everything setting in for you?
You know, it feels very surreal. It hasn't hit me, to be honest. But the fact that I'm here right now wearing the crown and the sash, I'm really proud of myself.
Well, I'm sure a lot of people also back home are proud of you. Was your family able to come in and support you? I know you're from the
yes.
Bay Area.
Yes, I actually had 2 family members fly from the States just to come watch me and be there for me that night. So I really appreciate their effort to come.
All right. And of course, we have Elaine and Anna Lee. Congratulations to both of you. Elaine, you're the tallest candidate. Of the crowd and one of the youngest, I guess. It's safe to say, right? One of the youngest.
I'm 20 years old now.
20, okay. Yeah. All right, well, maybe young compared to me. All right, Elaine, were you surprised with how everything kind of turned out for you during coronation night?
It was surprising talaga. Because this was my second national pageant. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And I was nervous on the stage. Parang, ito na ba yun?
Ano yung mga dumadaan sa
isip mo noon?
Because I remember I was watching the question and answer portion, yeah. And you know, there really was. I mean, they were hard. There were some tough questions out there that were thrown out with you guys. Natandaan ko yung pinapanood kita. Parang medyo you had to compose yourself a little bit para masagot mo na Filipino time ang gusto mong baguhin. So nagulat ka ba?
Nagulat talaga ako. Because I was so nervous na dapat ginalingan ko pa or yun.
Akala ko kinakabahan ka lang kasi katabi mo si Zian. Pero kadagdag na rin yun. Ikaw, Annalie, I saw the shock on your face when they called your number. What was going through your head?
Yes, kasi that time, I just, all one going on in my head, sabi ko, okay, I will go out and just stand there and be proud to the winners who will be there. And then, I'm very shocked. Oh my God, it's me, the first one. Nothing talaga. Talaga, blackout. And then, Ali, go to the stage. And then one of the floor directors, I cry backstage. And then he told me that, ano ka ba? Huwag ka umiyak. All of the people have done mistakes in their lives. Parang, ano yan? Parang isa challenge. Mm-hmm. Ang pinakamaganda sa challenge, mabangon ka, hindi ka na babaksak kung ano man yung naging pagkakamali mo. Parang yun yung sabi niya sa akin. Then, okay, stop crying. After that, when I play second runner-up, see what I tell you.
And you're alluding to the question and answer portion because there was a little bit of a,
yes.
Well, it was a challenging question, I guess, you know, for you. So we did have to kind of take two. Roll again, but it goes to prove that, you know, once you kind of hit a bump in the road, you just keep going, right?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Well, Janine, we just saw, you know, some footage of you actually getting that crown. Let's find out more about you ladies, because I know the nation wants to know more about you guys and people around the world do. Mamaya natin pag-usapan ng love life. But Janine, first off, you're 22, you graduated cum laude from UST.
UST,
which
pharmacy.
Pharmacy. That's very different from the path that you ended up,
that
you're pursuing right now.
Yes.
What were the original plans?
Honestly, my original plan is I'm going to study again. Mm-hmm. I was supposed to study again this year or work. Mm-hmm. Study abroad or work. And then one day, my mom just told me, you join again because you'll win. My mom told me that. And I was like, of course you'll say that because you're my mother. Mm-hmm. And then no, you join again. And then we thought about it, we discussed, and here I am.
Janine, magpapahula ako sa mama mo. Can I meet her? All right.
Go po. May bayad.
May bayad lang. Di bali naman. It seems like she's one for one so far. All right. Now, because you are going down this path, maybe plans will change. Are there any plans of joining show business? I know that Venus and Shamsi, those are doors that opened up for them. How about yourself?
I don't know. Kasi acting is not really good in it, but I think kung ano meron na mag-open na opportunity, I'll grab it.
And I have to ask, of course, because I always ask, do you have any male crushes in show business, you know, that you would like to be partnered up with or teamed up with?
Ever since I was a kid, I really love Jericho Rosales.
Jericho Rosales.
I really like him.
Yes. Okay. Well, pangako sa'yo.
Yes.
I was a fan of that as well.
Yes. Dami. Forevermore. Mga movies niya. So, pinapanood ko talaga lahat yun natin.
So, kung nanonood si Jericho ngayon, anong gusto mo iparating sa kanya?
He's dating someone,
right? That's true. Pero bilang isang tagahanga.
You are a very, very great actor, and I salute you. You're so good.
All right, yeah. Updated because I love that to Jericho. Wonderful.
Of course.
All right, now Nicole, tell us a little bit about yourself. I know one of the things that struck me about your bio is that you are taking home two degrees, right? Tell
in
us about
law
that.
Law and psychology.
That's amazing. Now, how did you do all that and still, you know, and still keep abreast on the pageant scene? Tell us about how you're balancing both worlds.
Well, I like to focus on one or the other. Mm-hmm. So I was joining pageants when I was younger, and then I took a break to complete my studies because it's very important. And then I've almost finished them now, so I came back to do the pageant.
Now, why those two degrees?
Because I love both. I was good at legal studies in high school, and I just love psychology, the way the mind works, and I want to be able to help people.
That's wonderful. Is there an area of law that you're interested in?
I like family law and media law, so like showbiz law, things like that.
All right, well, since you brought it up, now I have to ask you the same question as Janine. I mean, a lot of doors open up in show business after pageants. Are you interested in joining show business as well?
Well, that's not the reason why I joined the pageant initially, but of course, if there's offers, I will consider them.
Okay, but what's the plan? So you are taking home your law degree later on this year, correct?
Yes.
So you're going to be in the Philippines. Are you going to be going back to Australia? I know you're studying in Australia.
No, you have the option to complete it via correspondence, so I can focus on the pageant first and then finish it here via correspondence.
Well, wonderful. I think any jury or judge will might just be swayed to go your way if you have that crown on you and a little two-piece bikini. I'm just teasing. I'm totally teasing. All right, that's not going to work. Okay. Well, now, Katrina, we mentioned earlier that you're not necessarily from here. Has it been a culture shock? How have you adapted, I guess?
No, because even when I was in the States studying there, my whole family, like, we always followed all Filipino traditions, you know, like, there was always rice, we had the family parties and the gatherings. I speak Tagalog fluently, so it's not like it was any different coming back here again. And I was born here, so.
That's right. You were born in San Juan, correct?
San Juan, yes.
All right, so you would be very abreast in showbiz actors and in the scene. Who's your showbiz crush?
Me, I would have to say Derek Ramsey.
Derek Ramsey, all right. Yes. Well, he just won Box Office King.
Although, I know, congrats. Congrats on that.
And also, Wilton, aside from taking home the tourism crown, you also took home the Miss Talent Award. Do you mind sharing a little bit of your talent with us? I normally sing on the show, but I am passing the singing talent over to you today. Go ahead.
I'll go ahead and sing a little bit of the song that I sang during the talent portion. You can buy me diamonds, you can buy me pearls, take me on a cruise around the world, 'cause baby, you know I'm worth it.
We got Alicia Keys in the house.
Thank you.
Ron, I think she was trying to talk to you. Ron Cruz. Take a cruise around the world. Talking to one about wonderful. That's
thank you.
Now, are you entertaining the thought of show business, a singing career here in the Philippines?
I actually do want a career in singing or acting, whatever opens up, and modeling as well. But I'm gonna do that after I finish my reign as Miss Tourism.
Wonderful. Okay, yes. Now don't forget me as a backup singer. Okay.
I got you. Of course, of course.
You got me. I got some Bay Area love. All right, now, ladies. Now, also, Elaine, you played basketball. I know in your bio you played basketball in college.
Yes, I played for the UAAP for 2 years. I was a member of the National University Lady Bulldogs.
Wonderful. So ano yung reaction nila ngayon na nakita kanila na naka evening gown, girl na girl yung dating sa coronation night? Ano yung mga sinabi ng mga teammates?
They were surprised talaga, because before boyish ako. Loose shirts, shorts, and rubber shoes. Now I wear high heels and dress with hair and makeup.
Biglang kikay na. Now, when did that happen? After you?
After my first national pageant, then I go see the Philippine Fashion Week. I did that and a model competition in Korea.
Ah, wonderful. Okay, how are the guys? How are the guys on the men's basketball team treating this now?
No comment.
No comment. Nako, nahiya pa si Elaine to share sa atin ng love life. Anyways, well, okay. Now, Adelie, I know that you sing as well.
Yes.
That's your profession. Yes. Now, what are your plans after the pageant?
Maybe after the pageant. Maybe I concentrate first my responsibility in the Binibini Pilipinas. Mm-hmm. And then after the raining, maybe I can go work na and then some business.
Yeah. Do you mind if I ask you also for a little sample? I know you sang on Coronation Night.
Yes.
Also, singing showdown na tayo kahit konti. Go ahead, Adelie. Take us away.
Marami na akong nahalikan. Kay rami pang labing naistikman, kay rami nang napusuan, di na mapilang kung ilan. Ngunit ganun pa man, ikaw pa rin. Thank you.
Thank you, Adelie. Ako, We've got some shouts in the studio now. More. All right, guys, let's just all chime in together now. No, I'm just teasing. Wonderful. I think it's time for me to sing. No, I'm just totally kidding. No. Okay, now this is a question. This is why our studio is usually a little empty, but now we've got people filtering in, mostly men, all men. I'm gonna go down the row and you guys just tell me now, are you guys single or dating? I know it's a question on everyone's mind. Do you guys mind sharing? Annalie, I'll start with you. Single or taken?
Single.
Hindi narinig yung mga boys. One more time, guys. Single or taken?
Yes, I'm single.
Okay, that's Annalie. Elaine, single or taken?
Single.
Parang parang pilit yata yung sinabi ng single, labas sa ilo.
Am I?
It's complicated. It's not an acceptable answer. Katrina, single or taken?
I am single.
All right. Nicole, single or taken?
Single.
And Janine, single or taken?
I'm single.
Oh my gosh, we've got 5 for 5. All right, you ladies. Oh, it's gonna be a. Wala out ako dito sa question na to. It's gonna be a little fun year for you guys and all of your fans. All right, just tell everyone where they can kind of keep abreast with the Bidibiding Pilipinas activities. What's up ahead, just around the corner for you guys.
I'll start with the guestings. We will be on the bus on Sunday, and you can follow us on Binibining Pilipinas official, so you can see there our schedule of activities.
Wonderful. Go ahead. Anything you guys want to add? Go ahead, Nicole.
Just also, for the next couple of months, we'll be touring around every weekend around different malls in the Philippines with our sponsor, Nestle.
And Katrina?
And also, I know that for this year's Binibining Pilipinas, we're going to be a part of a lot of charities. We're going to be doing so much for this year, so just watch out for that.
We'll watch out for that. And Elaine and Annalie, anything you guys want to add?
Just follow us on Facebook and
there's
on
also
Twitter.
Facebook and Twitter as well.
Yes, and also please support our winners for their international pageants.
International pageants. We don't have the dates yet, but of course, I guess on the website people can find that out more. All right, well, Annalie, Elaine, Katrina, Nicole, Janine, thank you so much.
Thank you
It's been fun, and remember, that's 5 for 5 men, that's 5 single ladies, 5 single beauty queens that we have here for you. Thanks, guys. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And congratulations once again. Now, coming up, from fashion trends to political views, the attractiveness of a celebrity's lifestyle can influence people's beliefs. But how does a political endorser influence your vote? Join our discussion when we return. This is Mornings at ANC.